My sisters and brothers, we turn to God. We turn to God in these times of uncertainties. We turn to God for healing and for love and compassion. And we ask the good Lord to heal us of all those things that inhibit us from truly loving and being grace-filled. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Señor, ten piedad.
Reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus saith the Lord, return, O Israel, to the Lord your God. You have collapsed through your guilt. Take with you your words and return to the Lord. Save him, forgive all iniquity, and receive what is good, that we may render as offerings the bullocks from our stalls. Assyria will not save us, nor shall we have horses. We shall say no more, our Lord, to the work of our hands, for in you we often find compassion. I will heal their affliction, says the Lord. I will love their fear, for my wrath is turned away from them. I will be like the dew for Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall sprout root like the Lebanon cedar, and put forth his shoots. His fragrance shall be like the olive tree, and his fragrance like the Lebanon cedar. Again they shall dwell in his shade and raise grain. They shall blossom like the vine, and his fame shall be like the wine of Lebanon. Ephraim, what more has he to do with idols? I have humbled him, but I will prosper him. I but sinners stumble in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
An unfamiliar speech I hear. I relieve the shoulders of the burden. His hands were free from the mask. In distress, you call, and I receive you.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
Unseen, I answered you in thunder. I tested you at the waters of Meribah. Hear, my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, will you not hear me?
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, and well, as we know, these developments are continuing to regain restrictions. We offer our prayers for all the members of Mission San Buenaventura Parish and for all God's people throughout the world. And for further developments about mission ministries, please check the parish or mission website. But our offices are closed now, and if you need to communicate with us, probably email would be the best way to do that. You know, among the many hopeful texts that our Lord gives us in the scriptures, of the various prophetic books, today's first reading from the prophet Hosea is one of the most beautiful and poignant of readings. We hear in the text the voice of a loving God who has entered into a covenant relationship with his chosen people. It is analogous to a relationship between a husband and wife, a commitment to each other to love. Love God, God loves us. But you know, even when we don't love God or we turn away from God, God continues to love us. So our relationship with God is founded in love, but sometimes we err, we turn away, we forget, we question, and we even sin. But nevertheless, God's word is healing and life-giving. This is what is said to us today. I will heal their defection, says the Lord. I will love them freely, for my wrath is turned away from them. Simply put, however the capacity to receive this healing love, it comes only to us, when we turn or return to worship the one true God. And then in the Gospel today, the great teacher, Jesus, interprets all the law, the teachings. He gives us this beautiful guidance of the laws of Israel's God, and he asserts that it is completely summed up in the transformation of the human heart, in the transformation of our hearts. That's why during the season of Lent, we turn around, metanoia it's called, we turn around and back to God, to worshiping God, and to loving God, and to love God alone. This is the worship that is grounded in a profound affection for God, characterized and nourished by the right behavior that flows from those who are committed with great affection, great love, for God and neighbor. For when we love God rightly, we love God's world, we love what God has created, we love each neighbor, each member of our family, the neighbors down our streets, our community, our state, our nation, even our world. And if there is no other time that we are called to remember this, this coronavirus reminds us to be generous. Generous in our prayers, generous in our spirits, generous in not hoarding things for ourselves, but sharing them with all, so all will have plenty. So as we turn to God and ask God to put an end to this scourge, this coronavirus, and any of the sins of the world, let us show generosity to the God who continues to love us. You know, the readings today, they challenge us, don't they? But they also console us. They invite us to place all our energy of humanity in loving God, and loving God in service toward one another. Listen again to those beautiful words of the prophet. If only my people would hear me, and Israel would walk in my ways, I would feed them with the best of wheat, and with honey from the rock I would fill them. We ask the Lord to fill us with the beautiful grace of life and love and generosity.
Amen.
Now we offer our prayers. With love of God and neighbor, let us approach the heavenly throne of our needs and the needs of the world. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, may the Lord bless him, sustain him, and protect him from all evil, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our lawmakers, may the God of justice guide them in living out their duty with wisdom and a sense of service to all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who are marginalized or on the fringes of society, may the Lord provide for the acceptance and help that they need, especially the homeless in these cold and rainy days. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of our community of faith who throughout the world. May the Holy Spirit enkindle in us a more pure love for our neighbor. We pray, Lord,
hear our prayer.
And for all who have died, may they live forever in joy in the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the particular intention of this Mass, for Inez Sierra Santiago, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, you show your compassion and love to all who turn to you. Hear these prayers from your children, given in the name of Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
O Lord, hear my prayer. O Lord, hear my prayer.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, Lord, on the offerings we dedicate, that they may be pleasing in your sight and always be salutary for us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It is our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Veni Sus Filii et Verba,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, our Blessed Patrons, Buenaventura, Junipero Serra, Kateri Tegale, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Mis hermanos, fieles a recomendación del Salvador, y seguida divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir: Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos.
Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz.
también ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de turbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador, Jesucristo.
Tú eres el reino del poder y la gloria por siempre, Señor.
Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz os dejo y paz os doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia, conforme tu palabra, concede la paz a la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz, Señor, esté siempre con nosotros.
Y con tu espíritu.
Daos fraternamente la paz. Let us make a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you, and never permit me to be separated. by participating in this sacrament may bring us the fullness of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.